In this session, we are going to discuss about the finite set and infinite set. Now, what is meant by the finite set? The name itself says, if the set contains finite number of elements, we call that set as a finite set. Let us consider the set, an example, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, how many elements are there? 4 elements are there. So, we can say that it is a finite set because we can count the number of elements in the set. So, that we call it as a finite set. Then, what is meant by the infinite set? If the set contains infinite number of elements, we call those sets as an infinite set. Consider, if you consider the example, the set of the natural numbers. And you know that the set of the natural numbers will start from 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 4, up to so on. Here, you can observe that we cannot count the number of elements present in the set. So, we can say that this set is an infinite set. What is meant by the finite set? If the set contains finite number of elements, we call it as a finite set. That means, you can count the number of elements in the set, that we call it as a finite set. And what is meant by the infinite set? If the set contains infinite number of elements, we call it as an infinite set. Now, here, the next one, which is cardinality of the set. What is meant by the cardinality is nothing but the number of elements in the set we call it as a cardinality of the set. What is meant by the cardinality? It is nothing but the number of elements in the set is called the cardinality of the set. Here, and the cardinality of the set is denoted by the symbol n of which set we took, that set you need to write. N of A, n of B, any set. So, here, what is meant by the cardinality? The number of elements in the set we call it as a cardinality of the set. Let us suppose here they will ask what is the cardinality of this set. Then, you know that the cardinality of the set is denoted by the letter n of A. And what is meant by the cardinality? The number of elements in the set. You need to count the number of elements. How many elements are there in this? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, we can see that n of A is equal to 4. Let us suppose they have given here 5. And they will ask the cardinality of the given set A. Then, how many elements are there here? 5. You can count it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The cardinality of the set A is 5. And the cardinality of the infinite set that we will discuss in the higher classes. Now, what is meant by the finite set? If the set contains finite number of elements, we call it as a finite set. And if the set contains infinite number of elements, we call it as an infinite set. And what is meant by the cardinality? The number of elements in the set, we call it as a cardinality. And it is denoted by the symbol n of A. Now, here, let us see two examples about the cardinality of the set. Suppose if you have given two sets, let us consider the set A as 1, 2, 3, 4 and consider the set B which is 2, 4, 5, 8. And if suppose they ask, find the cardinality of, they will ask, find N of A union B. Then how do you find? Here N of A union B is nothing but you need to find the number of elements in the set A union B. This is the meaning of N of A union B. That means, you need to find the number of elements in A union B. Here, what we need to do if you want to calculate N of A union B, first we need to know how many elements are there in A union B. First, you have to find the number of elements in A union B. What is A union B? It's nothing but we have to write all the elements that are present in both A and B. So, write it how many elements that are present here. 1, 2, 3, 4 and after that, in a set, the elements cannot be repeated. So, no need to write 2 because we have already written. Similarly, 4 is also we have written. What's the next element which is 5 and which is 8. Now, we have written A union B. The set consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 8. If you want to find N of A union B, what it indicates? You need to write the number of elements that are present in A union B. So, find it. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here, the n of A union B is nothing but 6. Like this, you can calculate A intersection B. That means how do you find? First you need to find how many elements are there in A intersection B. Finding A intersection B. How do you find A intersection B? A intersection B is nothing but you need to write the common elements that are present in A and B. Now see what are the common elements in these two sets. You can see here 2 is the common element and 4 is the common element. So write it here 2 and 4. Now what is N of A intersection B is nothing but you need to write how many elements that are present in A intersection B. How many elements are there? Here 2 elements are there. Like that, if you have given any sets, if they ask to find N of A union B or N of A intersection B, you can find like this. Now there is a relationship between N of A union B and N of A intersection B. This is very important. What the relation says it here? Here is nothing but the relation between this one is N of A union B is always equal to N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. This one they will ask here, they will give some sets and they will ask to prove N of A union B is equal to N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. Now if you want to prove this one, let us consider two sets and find those one. Let us consider the set A as 2, 4, 5, 6 and let us consider the set B as 5, 6, 7, 8. Let us consider this one. If you have given these two sets and they are asked to verify N of A union B is equal to N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B, how do you solve? First you need to find the value of the LHS and after that you need to find the value of the RHS and after that you have to check whether it is true or false. Now here if you want to find the value of the LHS, first what we need to do? We need to find the value of A union B. Before that here write it here N of A. N of A is nothing but the number of elements in the set A. How many elements are there in the set A? Which is 1, 2, 3, 4. So N of A is 4. Similarly, what is the value of N of B? N of B is nothing but the number of elements in the set B. How many elements are there in the set B? Which is 1, 2, 3, 4. So write it here 4. Now, you need to find the value of the LHS. What is LHS? Which is nothing but N of A union B. Before finding the number of elements in A union B, we need to write what are the elements that are present in A union B. Right? What is A union B? A union B is nothing but we need to write all the elements that are present in A and B. So write it here for the first element, which is 2 and after that we have 4 and 5 and after that 6. We have already written 5 and 6 and what is the next element, which is 7 and after that 8. So we have written all the elements. Now find N of A union B. What is N of A union B? Just you need to count the number of elements that are present in A union B. How many elements are present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The value of N of A union B is 6. Now you need to find the value of the RHS. So before finding the value of the RHS, you know what is N of A and you know what is N of B. Now you need to find the number of elements that are present in N of A intersection B. Now here consider A intersection B. A intersection B is nothing but you need to write the common elements that are present in A and B. What are the common elements that are present here? 5 and 6. These are the common elements that are present in these two sets. So write it here 5 and 6. Now you need to write N of A intersection B, which indicates the number of elements in A intersection B. How many elements are present? 1 and 2. Now calculate the value of RHS. What is RHS now here? You can take here N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. What is the value of N of A? How many elements are present in A? Which is 4. How many elements are present in B? Which is again 4. And how many elements are present in N of A intersection B? Which is 2. Now calculate here what is the value of 4 plus 4, which is 8. Minus 2, you are getting here 6. So we got here the LHS as 6 and the RHS is also 6. From this we can construct here N of A u can be is always equal to n of a plus n of b minus n of a intersection b. This is a very important relation between the cardinality of the set. What it states here, n of a union b is always equal to n of a plus n of b minus n of a intersection b. That means if you have given any two sets, if you want to verify this relation, just you need to find the number of elements in A union B, A, B and A intersection B. After that, by the calculation you can prove here those two are equal. Now, based on this we are going to solve the next exercise. The next exercise, which is 2.4, in that the first question state which of the following sets are empty and which are not. Here they have given some statement, just you need to tell whether they are the empty set or non-empty set. What is meant by the empty set? You already discussed what is meant by the empty set. The set which does not contain any element, we call it as an empty set. And the empty set is denoted by the symbol like this or like this, and we call the empty set as the null set or the void set. Now see the first statement, what they have given here. The set of lies passing through the given point. Here what the statement given here? The set of lies passing through the given point. Let us suppose this is the point. How many lines we can draw passing through this point? So here you can draw many lines passing through this point, like this and like this, like this, right? From this what we can observe here, what is said here? The set of lines passing through the given point is an empty set or non-empty set. Here, you can clearly observe here so many lines that can pass through the given point. So, we can say that it is a non-empty set because it contains so many elements. So many, in this case, what are the elements which is nothing but the lines? So, here, if you have given any point, you can draw many lines. But here what they ask here, the set of lines passing through the given point is a non-empty set because we can find many number of elements that passes through the given point. Now, see the second question. What is the second question given here? The set of odd natural numbers divisible by 2. That means, is it an empty set or non-empty set? What they said here, the second question. First question, write the answer here. What they said, the set of lines passing through the given point is a non-empty set. Write it here. I am not writing the question. The given set is non-empty because what is the reason? Because we can draw many lines in a given point. That means if you have given any point, you can draw many lines passing through this given point. So we can say that it is a non-empty set. Similarly, see the second question. What they have given here? The set of odd natural numbers divisible by 2. So you need to tell whether it is an empty set or not. Before that, you need to write the set here. What is the set given here? The set of odd natural numbers divisible by 2. You have to state whether it is an empty set or non-empty set. That means what is an empty set? If the set does not contain any elements, we call it as an empty set. Now we need to know whether any elements are present in this set or not based on this condition. So here, what is the set given here? The set of odd natural numbers. What are the odd natural numbers? You know that 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. These are the odd natural numbers. And what they have given are divisible by 3. You know that any of the odd number is not divisible by 3. Which is divisible by 2 because you are not getting the remainder as 0. So we can say that it is an empty set because we did not get any elements that are present in this set. What is the set here? the set of the odd natural numbers. What are the odd natural numbers? These are the odd natural numbers, and you know that any of these numbers are not divisible by 2. But in the question, they have given that the set of odd numbers is divisible by 2. So we can say that since that set does not contain any elements, we can say that it is an empty set. So like here, it is an empty set. Why? What is the reason here? Because the odd numbers are not divisible by 2. Because you know that if you divide the odd numbers with 2, you will not get the remainder as 0. So see the next statement. In the third question, third one, what is the set they have given x such that x is a natural number? X less than 5 and x greater than 7. Now here, this is the condition they have given. You need to state whether this set is an empty set or not. That means you need to know whether any elements are present in this set or not. So here, you can observe that here, what is the condition given here? X less than 5 and x greater than 7. So what is the condition given here? X less than 5 and x greater than 7. You can write this one as 7 less than x. Anything is same. So write it here, 7 less than x. And what is the condition given here? And x less than 5. Here we got it here, 7 less than x and x less than 5. So from this you can write it here, 7 less than x less than 5. This is the condition we can write it. But you know that this condition is not possible, never possible here. You know that this is a raw inequation. From this you can observe that here this set is an empty set, because we cannot find any element that are present in this set. So write it here. What you can write here? The given set is an empty set because we cannot find any element satisfying the given condition. Here, based on this condition, we cannot find any natural number, so we can say that it is an empty set. Now, see the next question. In the first one, 4th and 5th, you can do it as an homework. Here, what's the question given here? This one, homework, in the first question, 4th option and the 5th option, you can do it. Here, what they have given, x is a common point to any parallel lines. That means here in the fourth question, what they have been just trying to explain, if you take any two parallel lines, then what they are saying here, you will get some common point to these parallel lines. You will never get a common point if you take any two parallel lines, because if you extend these parallel lines, it will extend like this, it will not intersect at any point. So we can say that it is an empty set. And the set, and the next one, the set of even prime numbers. So you know that is there any even prime number? Yes, you know that 2 is the even prime number. So we can say that since it contains at least one element, so we can say that it is a non-empty set. You can do these 2 as an homework. Now, see the second question. Second question, just I will explain this one also, you can do it as a homework. Here, what the question says here, just they have given some sets, you need to tell whether it is a finite set or not. What is meant by the finite set? If it contains the finite number of elements, we call it as a finite set. And then the first question they ask, the set of months in a year. You know that in a year how many months will be there? 12 months will be there, and we can count it. So we can say that it is a final set, right? And what's the next set they have given here? 1, 2, 3, and so on, 100. They ask whether it is a final set or infinite set. Here we can observe that by seeing the set itself, we can say here 100 elements are present in this set. Since we can count the number of elements in the set, so we can say that it is a finite set. What is finite set? Just we can count the number of elements. Here we know that 100 elements are present in this set, so we can say that it is a finite set. And here the next one, they ask a set of prime numbers smaller than 99. Here you need to write the prime numbers smaller than 99. So here you can observe, here you can write it and you can count it. How many elements are present in this set, right? What are prime numbers? 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and so on. We can count it before less than 99. So we can say that it is also a finite set, because we can count the number of elements present in the set. This one is your homework. And see the third question, which is the last question in this chapter. So what the third question says here, state which of the following set is finite or infinite. Before question, write that only. What's the first question given here? The set of letters in an English alphabet. You know that in an English alphabet, how many letters will be present? You can count it. So if you want to write the set, you can write it A, B, C, and so on. What's the next one, which is it? Right? So you know that it is a finite set because you can count the number of elements present in the set. So we can say that it is a finite set, right? And what is the second question given in that? The set of lines which are parallel to the x-axis. Here you know that this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis, right? And here what is set here? The set of lines which are parallel to the x-axis. Is it countable or uncountable? You can draw many lines that are parallel to the x-axis. You know that these are all the lines which are parallel to the x-axis. So we can say that it is an infinite set, because we cannot count the number of elements, or in this case the number of parallel lines present in the set. So we can say that it is an infinite set. Now see the third question in that. What is set here? The set of numbers which are multiples of 5. They ask here whether the multiples of 5 is a finite set or an infinite set. What is meant by the multiples of 5? You know that 5 is a 10, 5 is a 15, 5 4 is 20, 5 5 is a 25. If you go on, it keeps on going better. You don't know what is the last number to end this set, because if you go on like this, you will get the next number. So we can say that it is an infinite set because we cannot count the number of elements that are present in the set. So we can say that this set is an infinite set. And after that, the last question.